Hi everyone, good morning. For today's video, I'm doing ice machine maintenance. And I will show you how this ice machine works. Enjoy the video. And this is our ice machine, guys. This is Ice Cube ice machine. Brand is a Scotsman. This is a commercial ice machine and a good brand also. So we have two units here. But before we start, I will show you first the parts and the accessories of this machine. So I remove already the cover, front cover of the machine, and this is the one. It's the touch button and the signal, power, and alarm lights. And this is our ice bin, and there is already ice inside, ice cube, because I run the machine one cycle, so there is ice already. And, back side here, and we can find our the most important accessories of our ice machine, our water filter. The more expensive or the more the good quality filter we can provide for our ice machine is the more better, so that we can because we need a good quality filtered water going to our ice machine. We need a quality filtered water because this ice is used for human consumption. So that's how important our water filtration. So this is a ice machine. So of course there is a refrigeration system for making ice. So there is a compressor, and there is also right there backside our condenser unit, and backside there is our our condenser filter. This one is can be removed, and so that this one is removable, and time to time need to clean, because so that our ice machine will work properly, will work efficiently. So that's it. Now guys, we are here in the front of our ice machine, and I will show you some parts in our machine here in the front. And this is our power button, some LED lights for our power, signal and alarm lights, and inside of this box where we can find our control board, and here you can find also our service line of our refrigeration, and here is our distribution pump or our water pump, and this one is our reservoir or water refilling sensor. This one is our inlet water supply hose, and this one is the our pump hose going inside to our distribution pipe inside of this cover. And I will open this one, so I will remove this cover. And this one is our reservoir tank, and this cover has a magnetic switch, so when you remove this cover or this cover is hanging, this machine will not work. The machine will not start. It will be showing alarm here. So this cover has switch, so this is very important that this one is closed and not hanging, so that our machine will run. So now we will open this one and show you some parts inside. And this is our distribution pipe, our distribution jet, Downside of that is there's small hole or distribution jet. The water will flowing going here back to our reservoir when running time. And this is our ice cube thickness sensor. And this is the adjustment of our ice cube. If we want to adjust the size of our cubes, then we can adjust this this bolt. If you want the ice cube will become more bigger or more thicker, we can adjust this one to make this sensor coming up and going in. That is the adjustment of our ice thickness of our ice cube. So now I will show you how this machine works. Now guys, I will show you how this machine, how this ice machine works. But before that, I will use ladder to climb up there because I'm a short guy, I cannot reach. So I will show you now how this machine works, how this ice machine works, and how ice making cycle is done. So I forgot, this is our ice grid or our ice split. Backside of this is our evaporator coil, the one make cooling of this ice grid. So how it works, normally the ice machine, before it will start making ice, it will rinse by itself. Before and after making ice, it will rinse by itself so that the remaining or the used water inside the reservoir will drain out, will be flushed out, and some dirt in the reservoir tank will be drained out. So every time the machine run for making ice, using new water, the old water or the used water will be drained out through into the drainage of our distribution pump. This pump is double purpose for distribution of the water inside of this reservoir tank, distribute going up here in our distribution jet, and also use as a drainage pump motor, throwing the water also in this reservoir water going out to the drainage. So now how the machine works. So first, when you on the machine, this one will fill water to the our reservoir tank, and when the level of the water is reaching to our water level sensor, the water will cut, and this distribution pump will run and pump up, distribute all the water in our reservoir going to our distribution pipe, distribution jet going down back to our reservoir, back and forth for a few minutes. And after that, there's a backside, there's a drainage solenoid valve, that one will open, and this distribution pump or water pump will throw all the water inside of this reservoir tank will be drained out. And after that, refill new water in our reservoir tank, and our compressor backside will run and starting the making of the ice. So making of the ice, so this distribution pump or water pump will pump all the water here in our reservoir tank going here, and the water will flowing here in our ice grid. This ice grid is cooling, so gradually that water will forming in this grid. Making of the ice is like 15 to 20 minutes. It depends upon the temperature of the water. If like summer time,
the water temperature is very hot, so it takes like 20 minutes or more than before we can harvest the ice. When the winter time, the water is cool, so only like maybe 15 minutes or less than 15 minutes. The ice will be harvested because the water temperature is cool, not taking long time to our evaporator to form the ice in our ice grid. So continue flowing of the water from here in our distribution jet, flowing going down here back to our reservoir for like 15 to 20 minutes. Then when the thickness of our ice will reach touching this ice thickness sensor, our machine will defrost, our bypass solenoid will on, and this ice grid or ice plate will become hot, and that ice cube will fill down, and that is the harvesting of our ice. So only like that. Then after harvesting the ice, all the ice will thrown here again. The remaining water here in our water reservoir tank will be flushed out, will be drained out, and refill new water. Again, the compressor will run, and again, the ice making cycle is starting. So only like
this. This is the actual operation of our ice machine. So you can see now here, there's a flow of water coming from our distribution jet, pumped out by this distribution pump, coming here in our reservoir tank. The water is only circulating from the reservoir tank, pumping, going up to our distribution jet, back and forth, until this cold water will become ice and ready to harvest. So that's all, guys. And if you like or find this video useful, please do like and subscribe and click the notification bell below for more videos. Thank you.